ذلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيه إليك وما كنت لديهم إذ أجمعوا أمرهم وهم يمكرون. صدق الله مولانا العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد معدن الوجود والكرم وآله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. صلاة وسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. Inshallah, that's the last section, last ruku. Inshallah, we're going to go through the translation and viewpoints of these verses. If you can recall, the purpose why the sabab, why this surah was revealed is because when the Meccans, Quraysh, they challenged the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, if you are truly a prophet of Allah, then mention to us the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. After mentioning the whole story, the incident, the qissah of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِي إِلَيْكَ. So this is from the news of the unseen, which we have revealed to you. And this story was from ghayb. No one knew the actual story of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. But we have revealed this to you. These are such verses of the Quran which prove that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam possessed the knowledge of unseen. Allah is himself saying, ذَلِكْ مِنْ أَمَّا الْغَيْبِ نُوحِي إِلَيْكَ. That this is from the news, the story from the ghayb which we have revealed to you. So hasn't Allah subhanahu wa taught the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the ghayb? Of course he has. Now another very important point to remember is which is the most ghaib, the most hidden. Who is the most hidden? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is there anything which is more hidden than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? His zahir and batin, his hidden. But his qudra, his rahmah, his knowledge, his power is clear. But no one has seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People have seen prophets, people have seen angels, people have seen other books. But no one except the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his naked eyes has seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no one hidden than Allah. Then if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not hidden to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then what thing can be hidden from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you know when Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when he requested Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this comes in the qissa of Mi'raj, he himself asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi arini anzur ilayk. O Allah, I want to see you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa alayhi salam, lan tarani, you're not able to see me. However, because Musa alayhi salam requested, it was a supplication, dua of a prophet to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, okay, I will shine my tajalli. Now what is a tajalli? Tajalli means a reflection of a light. So I am gonna shine a tajalli of my light. And how much was that? Ulama, tafsir al-ma'ani, tafsir al-bayan, and other mufassirs, they have stated, equal to an eye of a needle. That amount of tajalli, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shone on Mount Tur. And Allah says, فَإِنْ اسْتَقَرَّ مَكَانَهُ فَسَوْفَ تَرَانِي. If that mountain was to stay on its face, فَسَوْفَ تَرَانِي, then you will be able to see me. You know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reflected a tajalli of his light, it was not an actual light. It was a reflection. Musa alayhi salam fell unconscious. Khara Musa sa'iqa. Musa alayhi salam was not able to perceive that small amount of tajalli of the actual light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He fell unconscious. And some of us have stated, he remained unconscious for 1 week. And do you know when he woke up after a week, his eyes have become so brilliant, so sharp, so strong, that he could see a black ant walking on a black stone in the middle of night, 30 miles away. Oh. This is when Musa alayhi salam was not able to perceive a tajalli. Now what can we say about the actual eyes of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any veils? Huh? So there is no ghaib to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Obviously, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the ghaib, knowledge of unseen. ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْكَ. And that is from the news of the unseen which we have revealed upon you, O Prophet of Allah. So Quraysh are listening to this. Now the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to illustrate here that O Quraysh, O Jews, you have to admit, no doubt this surah is being revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as you know, in Makkah Sharif there were no Jews, there were no Christians. In Medina to Munawiyah, yes, at that time when the Quraysh went and they asked the Jews, what question can we pose to the Prophet of Islam that we can determine whether he's Prophet of Allah or not? He said, ask him about Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam. So in Makkah to Mukarramah there were no Jews. So they had to believe that this surah, no doubt, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And most men will not believe, even though, O Prophet, you're haris, you're eager for them to accept Islam. Allah subhanahu wa saying, even after we have revealed the surah, they will still disbelieve. خَتَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ. Allah has sealed their hearts. No matter what mu'jizat they are shown, they'll disbelieve. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was eager, haris, for them to accept Islam, said here, this is the surah. This is the place of Yusuf alayhi salam. Accept Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala foretold him, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. The majority of people, even though you're eager for them to accept Islam, they will not accept Islam. وَمَا أَتَسْأَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرِ. And O Prophet, you also mentioned to them that you do not ask for reward for this. Oh, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will propagate deen only for the sake of Allah. Not for any greed, any fame, any wealth, nothing. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرُ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed this surah and this Qur'an, this wahi is admonition, is a reminder for those of the world. And O Prophet of Allah, don't worry. If they don't accept Islam after listening to the surah, don't worry. Why? وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ مِنَ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمَرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَلَيْهَا مُرِدُونَ. How many signs there are of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They go past every day. آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The signs that Allah exists. The sign that Allah is one. Look at how birds are flying. How clouds are formed. How rain forms and showers. Look at all creation, we were made out of one dot, sperm, one cell, an egg, and here we are human beings, walking, talking, thinking. Look at the sun, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. Look at, for example, look at the eye. If you see something very bright, the iris will contract. If it's very dark, they'll expand. Okay, the three small bones in our ears, and then the cornea, we have that link to the brain. How the waves, okay, they go into the ear and then they vibrate the bones and then they're able to perceive. And even to such an extent, you'll understand where the sound is coming from. If you close your eyes, you know the sound is coming from there, it's coming from there, it's coming from the rear, from the front, from above, from bottom. It's all from that three bones. Subhanallah. And then look at the nose. You can sense, you can smell different smells. Samosas today, pakoras tomorrow. You know, lasagna the other day. All the different senses Allah has instilled in our nose. If you open the nose, you won't find it. Chip. Oh, this is it. Subhanallah, look at the taste buds. Okay? This is amazing. This tongue is amazing. You can taste it. Yeah, they cannot produce anything like the tongue. Look at even the teeth. Every single tooth is perfect. Okay, we have canines, molars, premolars. We've got dentists here, mashallah. I'll stop here. Huh? But subhanAllah, that even these
canines is a sign that we can eat meat. The Hindus just say, oh, humans shouldn't eat meat. But why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this? Okay, we're canines. But can we eat veg and meat? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as soon as we're fasting now, yeah, as soon as we go home, we're going past after Salat al-Maghrib, subhanAllah, this area. You can smell samosas everywhere. As soon as we smell something, it creates saliva. Yeah, what's in saliva? Enzymes. It helps to digest food. Okay, now, individual tooth. Now, it is not one bone. It is not one bone, it's individual bones. That even if you were to break one, you've got others that help you to survive. Imagine if you had one bone only, and that would break. Maybe like that, very soon. Yeah, and then how we swallow food, and then we have the muscles in our throat, how the food can go down. We can swallow it. Everything, even blinking. Do you ever say, okay, now blink, open, blink, open? No, don't. Okay, heartbeat. Who told you, do the first thing ever in the, when there's fetus, when the baby's formed, even before the nervous system, even before the brain has been formed properly, the first thing happens is the beating of the heart. Two syllables. Do, 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 do. Why two? Of course, the chambers, that's another thing. But why two? It's because it's saying Allah, 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 Allah. That is why the Prophet says every child is born as a Muslim. On fitrah, on nature, our heart says that Allah, Allah. Our very essence of our life is saying Allah, Allah, Allah. Why do you deny the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is this what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying? And then the whole system in our organs. I mean, every single thing. You know, you do these studies, tens and 20 years of study, then you become an expert of one organ. Of your teeth, or tongue, or eyes, or ears, your skin. Even the skin is subhanAllah, amazing how it works. So, وَكَأَيِّ مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهِ They go past. You yourself, you are a sign that Allah exists. Why do you deny? وَهُمْ عَلَيْهَا مُرِدُونَ And they're turning away from these signs. Allah, at the very beginning, تِلْكَ مِنْ آيَاتٍ Those are the signs. These verses are signs. Every single verse is a sign of Allah. So the Prophet of Allah, even if they turn away from these signs, they're already turning away from these signs upon signs. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثُرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ And even if majority, if they believe in Allah, but most of them, they're polytheists. There are many mushrikun in Makkah al-Mukarrama who just believe in Allah, Hindus. They believe in ultimate God. But they believe in other idols. The many mushrikeen like that, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty. But they also believe in other false gods. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now warning them. Okay, you think just because the Prophet is in Makkah al-Mukarrama, no punishment, this is the rahmah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that even you're denying the mu'jizat of the Prophet of Allah, even though you're denying the signs of Allah, Allah doesn't shower His adab upon you like He did to Qawm Aad and Thamud. أَفَأَمِنُوا أَن تَأْتِمْ غَاشِيَةٌ مِنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ Are you in safety? You know, do you think you are in amn, you are fearless? The adab will not come to you. أَوْ تَأْتِيَهُ السَّعَ بَغْتَةً Or the qiyam will come to you suddenly. People do that. Now, sa'a, one thing to remember. The ulama, they have said there are two types of qiyama. Qiyama sughra wa qiyama kubra. Qiyama sughra, the ma'na qiyama is when you pass away. There's no coming back. That's it, finish. Your book of deeds are closed. Okay, whatever you're going to take from this dunya, you took. Whatever you spent in this dunya, you spent. Okay, you'll be in a grave. Only two things will come with you. Your kafar and your amal. Nothing else. This is qiyama sughra. So death will come suddenly. And when it comes suddenly, khalas. You know that, and then it's qiyamah al-kubra, the major qiyamah, when everyone will be resurrected. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ says, considering qiyamah al-sughra al-kubra, the signs, if before the signs of qiyamah al-sughra and qiyamah al-kubra come, If you repent, Allah will accept your repentance. And one is sakratul maut. When you're on, you know, about to die, you can see your agonies of death, sakratul maut. You now you see angels coming to you, angels of rahmah or angel of punishment. You see the angel of death in front of you. And then you tawbah, ya Allah, do tawbah, ya Allah, now accept Islam. Khalas, no. Fir'aun, same thing. Fir'aun, when he was about to drown, when he was drowning, he said, I believe in the Rabb of Musa wa Harun. Allah said, Al-An, now you believe? It's no. Okay, as soon as death comes to you, you can't do tawbah. You won't be accepted. And the second is when the sun rises from the west. At the moment, the doors of tawbah open. Not only Ramadan, after Ramadan, any time during the day, in 24 hours, you raise your hand, ya Allah, I want to do tawbah, Allah will accept the tawbah. Okay? But these are blessed times to do tawbah. Okay? There's more chances that when you tawbah in these blessed days, that you become firm on the tawbah. Istiqamat al-deen. But as soon as the sun rises from the west, Allah will request the angel to close the doors of tawbah. Then people will disbelieve, oh yeah, the Muslim was saying, one of the signs of Qiyam is the sun will rise from the west here. Even some scientists, they say that, okay, that the sun will rise from the west. But then it will be too late. Khalas. You had an opportunity, you saw these signs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you've seen all these signs. Even if you ponder upon your own self, if non-Muslim atheists, if they were to ponder upon their own creation, why was I created? What is the purpose of human beings? Why me? Okay, even just pondering on that, they understand there must be a purpose of their lives. And what is the purpose of their lives? وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not created humans, Allah has not created jinns except to worship Allah. Our coming to this dunya is not to hold wealth, mansion, cars and business. Yeah, that's fine. That's means of having a good life. But the ultimate aim of a Muslim should be to please Allah. If nowadays, the youth I'm talking to, if you ask if they are colleges or university, what is the point of going to university? Oh, I want a degree. Why do you want a degree? Oh, I want a good job. Why do you want a good job? Because I want to earn more. Why do you want to earn more? It's because I want a peaceful life. Why do you want a peaceful life? I don't know. There's a full stop there. The full stop should be there. There should be a comma. The end should be is to please Allah. The ultimate aim of our lives is to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many youth, they don't have that vision. And that's why they get misled very easily into drugs and alcohol and relationships and domestic problems. Imagine that. Because even the husband and wife, their aim is not to please Allah. As soon as every individual society, from an alim to a student, every single person, their aim is they want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have a peaceful life. But people neglect that. People have, they're so concerned about their dunya, about their work. What's going to happen? Allah is Razzaq. Don't be, you pray 5 times a day and you tawakkal on Allah, Allah will provide. Don't worry. Okay, you don't worry about your life. You have one objective. That objective is Allah has created you to please Him. You please Him, Allah will please you in the sunnah and akhirah. Okay, this is guaranteed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ and they are aware. And the Prophet ﷺ is then told to inform the people, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. O Quraysh, O Meccans, O Jews, O Christians, O people, this is my path. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, which I'm calling you towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Me and those who are my followers, the companions, the Muslims, they have an insight. Basira. They have a purpose of life, objective life. Wa subhanallah, and praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Glory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pure is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ma ana min al-mushrikeen. I am not from the polytheists. I'm no mushrik. I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, Meccans, these false gods you're worshipping, what's the point? Man-made gods, I'm calling you towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's created everything. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقُرَىٰ. And you have not said before you, O Prophet of Allah, except men. I we send now men as messengers. نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْهِمْ that we have revealed wahi towards them. مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقُرَىٰ and they are from the people of the city. I all the Prophet عليه السلام, they lived among people. They lived in cities and towns and villages. They lived among the people because they were sent to guide people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to say, O Quraysh, you've seen the Prophet ﷺ for 40, 50 years. Never he said, uttered words of falsehood. You've seen his character, his behavior, his attitude, his haya, his rahmah, his mercy. And yet you disbelieve him. أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُ فِي الْأَرْضِ Don't you walk on earth? Go, circle, walk on earth. Sightseeing. Huh? Not the Big Ben I'm talking about. I'm talking about the upper sightseeing. Look at the earth, the seas, and the nature. فَيَنْظُرُ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ And let them look, let them observe and watch the end of those who came before them. Do you know the Quraysh would go to Syria for business trips and they would go to the place of the Qawm of Thamud and Aad, the mountains. And how do you know, even the Prophet once went past that place, the Prophet said, run, because the Azab of Allah came to this place. They go past, look at the ruins. And probably, I don't know how true it is, they're digging that place and found a massive skeleton, size of this room. Probably the Qawm of Aad or Thamud, wallahu alam. But then again, objective life. وَلَدَارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا The abode hereafter, the place hereafter, Jannah is the best for those who are God-fearing. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ Don't you understand? حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا جَاءَهُمْ نَصْرُنَا And so many times, when other prophets, عليهم السلام, they propagated deen, and they would not accept Islam, they felt helpless. That no one is accepting Islam, this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then these prophets say, if you don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the adab of Allah will come surely upon you. So they would mock the prophets. Where's the adab of Allah? Go on, pray to your God. We're waiting for your adab, astaghfirullah. Yeah, and you know, the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala waits. Allah doesn't send his adab when the prophets are living among people. As soon as the prophets leave, then adab will come. وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا And the people thought the messengers have told them false information that you said the adab is coming, it's not. فَنُجِّيَ مَنْ نَشَاءُ جَاءَهُ نَسُرَ And then our help, our support came to the prophets. The adab came. فَنُجِّيَ مَنْ نَشَاءُ We save those whom we wish. وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَأْسُنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ However, the torment of Allah, the punishment of Allah cannot be diverted from those who do wrong. And the right the last verse, to conclude the whole qissa of Sayyid Yusuf alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ Indeed, in the story of Yusuf and his brothers, in the stories of previous prophets, عِبَرَة is a lesson. لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ For those of intellect. Look, intellect. You understand? Do you know the three types of knowledge? The three types of knowledge. The first type is called علم اليقين. Let me give an example. Let's say, for example, a child goes to school first time ever. And Allah and the teacher, she writes on the board, fire burns. Full stop. That's one type of knowledge. That's first level of knowledge. And then the second level of knowledge that she takes a piece of paper and she burns paper. Ah, fire burns. They've observed. And the third is when a child, naughty child, then puts his finger into the fire. Let me check, does it really burn? Oh, it does burn. This is the third level. Yes? Do you know we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is our first level. We believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we need to progress. Okay, with our piety, we go to second level, we see the qudrat of Allah in everything. We see the rahmat of Allah in everything. We see the power of Allah everywhere. Allah exists. There will be no doubt. And if you want to stay in the first level, there's a high possibility shaitan will come and take iman from you. Pray doubt. If you're on second level, and the Prophet said third, he saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his naked eyes. And a shaheed, again from that level, right there. Shaheed, a witness. So this is a lesson. مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى. This is not a story made up. Oh Quraysh, you've heard, you're eloquent, you're Arabs. Oh Jews, you know the story well. The story of Yusuf alayhi salam, of Quran, has more detail than the story mentioned in Torah and in Bible, and in all the New Testament. This has more detail. This can't be made up by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not man-made book. It is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى. This is no hadith, a story made up. However, four things Allah mentioned about this qissa. وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. However, this is a confirmation to Torah and Injil, which came before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. تَصْدِيقَ وَتَفْصِيلَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. This is tafsir, explanation of everything. وَهُدًا. It is guidance. وَرَحْمَةً. It is mercy. لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنِينَ. For those who believe. So this is end of Surah Yusuf. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that this, the conclusion of this surah is four things. This surah is tasdeeq, it's tafsir, it is huda by guidance, and it is rahmah. So for believers, we need to read, and the more you read, the beauty of Quran is, the more you read, you never get bored of it. You know, if you read, probably some of you read the Harry Potter series, 8-9 volumes. If I tell you, read it again, then amen. Yeah? But how many times did you surah al-Fatiha? Okay, every time you surah al-Fatiha on your own, you find it, it's beautiful. You never get bored of it. Same with these stories of the Anbiya alayhi salam. Even though most of you know the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. But every time you read it, you learn something new. It's amazing. This is a miracle itself. You know, and this is the Quran that we need to not only inform ourselves, our family members, our neighbors in our community, especially our non-Muslims in our community. And inshallah, because the masjid has been built, I hope, inshallah, in the future, we get non-Muslims coming more into the masjid. Let's teach them about Islam. It is one opportunity, okay, that we teach them the goodness of Islam. We need to portray when the only Islam they've been taught is through BBC, CNN, Sky News. Again, we are sleeping. Let's answer the Talmud. No. Okay, why don't you have that just by you? No. If they are mocking our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I'm going to go out and tell this is the seed of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the beautiful life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is handsome outwardly and inwardly. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is beautiful. We need to teach the Prophet, the people who the Prophet is. People, another thing, when people do da'wah, they always talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran and science, the Quran is word of Allah. We always forget the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? Why don't you propagate deen through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Gives a gift. You've got books in Syrian English. You've got work colleagues at work. Okay? You know, the birthday, this is a gift from it to you. You never know. You gifted that book to your friend at work, they might read it one day and they might accept Islam. Yes, so these are means of we need to somehow in this country we need to start expanding, go beyond our community. We worked so many years in our community, those came who came, those who left, who left. But still, we need to start, you know, giving a good image, portray and paint a good picture of Islam to the outer world. And alhamdulillah, if you do that with mukhlis, okay, inshallah, Allah will give us success. You know, there are approximately 2 million Muslims in this country, 2 million. 6 million francs. If we 2 million, if you were to work on one individual, one non-Muslim a year, how many would be at the end of the year? 4 million. But unfortunately, what's happening, even the Muslims themselves are going down.
Okay, the Muslims who are born and bred in the Islamic family, they're leaving Islam. Okay, so there's a lot of challenges we face. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Sultan Sayyid Yusuf alayhi salam, when we get the ability to propagate the true teaching of Islam, inshaAllah. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى الوجود والقرن وآله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. ربنا 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 اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك التواب الرحيم. أستغفر الله ربي من كل ذنب وأتوب إليه. أستغفر الله ربي من كل ذنب وأتوب إليه. أستغفر الله ربي من كل ذنب وأتوب إليه. اللهم اغفر وارحم وانت خير الراحمين. اللهم اغفر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. اللهم ارحم أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم تجاوز عن أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اصلح أحوال أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اجعلنا من أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. اللهم اجعلنا من التوابين واجعلنا من المتطهرين واجعلنا من عباد الصالحين. اللهم اجنا من النار. اللهم اجنا من النار. اللهم اجنا من النار. يا مجير يا مجير يا مجير. اللهم اني اسالك الجنه وما قرب اليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب اليها من قول وعمل. رب ارحمهما كما ربيا صغيرا. ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى الوجود والكرم وآله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. بفضل سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، والسلام والمسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين.